Okay, this is Drums4U at 2, episode 9. It's May 26th, May 27th. And I'm just going to noodle around a little bit before we get started. So, here it is. So, like I said, it's Drums4U at 2. This is the ninth one of these I've done, Tuesday nights, late night. Just a little drum hang, and I want to thank the people who have been supportive, you know, those who have thrown some tips my way, those who've given me some supportive and helpful comments, and all the encouragement, and those who've shared my posts and stuff, so I don't know what I'm doing here. I'm not a front man. I'm not supposed to be talking to people, but there are no gigs. I'm here in the studio, so this is what I'm doing. I do appreciate the people who come on and check it out. I do not... Oh, now it's showing again. I got some weird thing. Those of you who know OBS and, you know, the Facebook Live thing, where after I stream it, you know, after I start the streaming... in the little Facebook window, all of a sudden it just goes and says, sorry, we're having trouble viewing this video at this time, or something like that. It seems to be still working for the audience, but I can't see it. It just came back on. But if anybody has any clues about what I could do to get rid of that, that would be cool. Because when it's not on, I can't even tell if anybody is watching, which is probably good. I got two friends out there right now. Do you guys have the courage to tell me who you are? Shout out. Let me know you're there. I dare you. And then please chime in if you have any comments or questions, or if the sound is bad, if it's distorting. I think I might be a little bit hot. So let me know if it's distorting, and I'll back that off a little bit. Do a little bit right now. And so today what I'm going to do is I'm going to do a play along with a Dave Weckl track. Dave Weckl's a very famous drummer, for those of you who don't know, and he's done a lot of educational things, a lot of books, a lot of DVDs. I think he has a whole, basically a music school online. And he's a great studio drummer, and live as well. He got really famous when he was playing with Chick Corea many, many years ago when I was in high school. I went and saw them. And he's a beast. He's done a lot of play-along stuff. This is off one that's called... Dave Weckl In Session with the Dave Weckl Band. So this is actually an album that they did as a band, and then he went through and took the drums out and wrote, you know, gave us charts so that we can go through and play with the band. One thing about most play-alongs is that they're usually done with a metronome, so that when somebody's playing along, everything's right where it belongs, you know, so it's easy. But in this one, they didn't. They did not use a metronome when they recorded, so sometimes, you know, it flows, it ebbs a little bit. They're really good. It's solid. But as a play along, you got to really use your ears and listen. And if they move a little bit behind the beat or ahead of the beat, try to stay with them. I haven't played this tune in a million years, but we're going to give it a try at your expense. Oh, look. Denny Clark, good to see you here, brother. Thank you. Lee Jordan, man. I miss you, dude. I haven't seen you in, oh, man, decades. So I don't know if you're living in Cleveland or what. Let me know, man. Let me know what your situation is. Shoot me a private message or something. Let me know what's going on. Lee Jordan is a great saxophone player. At least he was. At least he was when I saw him decades ago. And an excellent human being, man. I always had a good time hanging out. So, anybody else? Like I said, if it's distorting or it sounds bad, hit me up. Let me know. I'm not gonna just sit here and talk all night. In fact, I'm gonna try to make this one a little shorter than some of the other ones. I get a little long-winded. All right, so this is actually Mud Sauce is the name of this song. And it is a New Orleans-based thing. I'm going to do another one of these or like some kind of, you know, YouTube lesson or whatever on New Orleans music, second line. And it'll be my version. If you want to watch somebody who really lives this stuff, check out my friend Johnny Vidakovich. Johnny Vidakovich is one of the great, great New Orleans drummers. He was a mentor and a teacher to some of my favorite drummers, Brian Blade and Stanton Moore. And I actually had, I might have already told the story on one of these, but I had an amazing drum lesson at Johnny's house one time, man. He was so cool to me. So check out Johnny. Also check out Stanton Moore, Herlin Riley. There's a lot of these great New Orleans drummers. So the essence of this is that it's based on a clave or a clave, if you're hanging with Johnny. And this one is a 3-2 sewn clave. So what that means is there's three hits in the first bar and two in the second. And we're all used to hearing it like Bo Diddley, have you heard, right? Dunk, 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 dunk. Or whatever generation you're from. I want candy. Dunk, 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 dunk. Or whatever. There's a trillion tunes that have that at the root. You can flip that around and make a 2-3 clave. 1-2-3-4, 1-2-3-4, 1-2. It's the same thing with the bars flipped. And then there's a great variation, which is 1-2-3 and. So that's that on whatever bar has the 2 in it, the second one's delayed. 1-2-3 and. 1-2-3-4, 1-2-3-4, 1-2-E. Sorry, it's E. 1-2-E-3. All right, so this one is the 3-2, and one thing you might notice it feels different from a lot of the music you're used to hearing, but not know why, and it's because of the semi-swung eighths or sixteenths. In this case, I'm thinking of them as sixteenths, but I want to do a whole lesson on that at some point, but the idea is that it's not completely straight. This would be straight. And this would be totally swung, one triplet, two triplets. But all the sweet stuff, a lot of the sweet stuff, is somewhere in the middle. So if I play that straight, very computer-like, it doesn't have a ton of, I don't know, pizzazz. But if I totally swing it, I like that a little bit better, but to me it's just a little bit cheesy. But if you find one of those sweet spots in the middle, then we'll sit there. So that's what I'm going to try to do. Like I said, I haven't played this tune in a million years. Enough talking. Here is anybody around? Danny's watching from Florida. Cool, man. I think I'm going to be going there in a couple weeks, which would be, where would I be? Largo, Florida. Not Key Largo, but Largo over by Clearwater and stuff. And then Lee says he's living in Georgia. That's cool, man, and doing some singing. Better you than me. I sing like a dying animal. All right, here we go. Here's Mud Sauce.
Thank you.
All right. So that was my attempt at mud sauce. I should really go back and shed that one. For those of you who don't know what shed means, it means to practice. And, you know, go out in the woodshed and practice. That's where that came from. And I need to do it. So let's see what's going on. I don't know where St. Augustine is, brother. Is that close to where I said I was going? Thanks, Danny Clark, for all the kind words, man. You're my new best friend. I got that thing back again. Sorry, we're having trouble playing this video. So I have no idea if anybody's watching, except Danny Clark was watching a few minutes ago. So if you're still there, I love you, brother. Let's talk about ECM. What is ECM music? It's a style of music, but it's actually also a record company. So ECM, like I said, was a record company, and they tended to sign a lot of artists who had a similar approach to music. I mean, it's very, very open and free kind of style with a lot of room for individuality. But at the same time, it tends to have some elements that are make it recognizable. All right. And one of those is that it has jazz sensibilities, I like to say. In other words, you approach it like jazz. You react to the soloist, and there's a lot of freedom in there. But it tends to be straight eighth notes instead of swing. So when I talk about swing, we're used to hearing in jazz. So that's swing. But in ECM, we tend to play more straight. And a lot of cymbals. A lot of cymbals going on in the ECM stuff. So who can we listen to check out the whole ECM style? Well, I really recommend the early Pat Metheny stuff. Pat Metheny is a legendary guitar player. He's still out doing amazing things. He's reinvented himself a million times. He can play so many styles. One of the most dedicated musicians on earth. He'll show up to a gig and practice all day before the gig. So Pat Metheny, M-E-T-H-E-N-Y, his earlier stuff. His first album was with Jaco Pastorius and Bob Moses, called Bright Size Life. Check that out. That's some early ECM stuff. And then his, several albums after that were all in the ECM vein. And then, he still holds on to that a lot. I don't think he's on the ECM record label anymore, but he kind of held on to that style for a lot of his stuff. So check that out. His drummer on the early stuff is Danny Gottlieb, and he's an amazing drummer, really, really beautiful. Then I've also, Pat Metheny has just used some of the greatest drummers of all time. I just saw him with Nate Smith, which was mind-blowing. That guy, he'll just, with his right hand, just go, brrr, I have no idea what he's doing. Also, check out his stuff on the Tiny Desk Concerts. If you haven't checked out Tiny Desk Concerts, they're on YouTube. They're from NPR. They're really well done. If you just go on there and surf, you'll find a lot of cool stuff. So Nate Smith's on there is awesome. Also, Antonio Sanchez played with Pat Metheny. Brian Blade. One of my favorite drummers, and I'm blanking out. Bill Stewart, man. Check that stuff out, too. Jack DeJohnette. So Jack DeJohnette is another drummer who plays a lot in the ECM style and even had his own band, Jack DeJohnette's New Directions. That's some cool ECM stuff to check out. Also, John Abercrombie, world-famous guitarist, does a lot of stuff in that vein. So once that'll get you started. Once you get in there, you can, like all other music, follow the family tree, see who played with who, and then check out their stuff and you'll find some cool things. So There is a play along out there by a man named Steve Houghton. Is it A-U-G-H-T-O-N? And he's done some really good play-along books. This one has what's called an ECM vamp. A vamp is just a repeated section of music. Okay, so somebody might say vamp until the vocals come in, or vamp until the melody comes in. It means you're just playing a one or two or whatever, a short little phrase over and over, and then when the melody comes in, the song form begins. You could also vamp in the middle of something. Sometimes they'll say solo over a vamp, which is what we're going to do now. The band keeps playing the same thing over and over, and the drummer, in this case, me, tries to play within those parameters and get expressive over the top of that. And you could vamp at the end. You could vamp until the mixing engineer brings the faders down, like so vamp to fade in a, whatchamacallit, like a musical. You could have something that says vamp till cue, which means you're just doing a little thing while there's probably some dialogue going on, and then either the musical director or the dialogue cues you to go on with the music. So a vamp just means you're repeating a little thing. This is like not even 3 minutes long. It's just a little dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun. That's it. It just keeps doing it. I'm going to try to mess with the time a little bit on it. When we talk about messing with the time, we're saying that we're kind of going to not play everything so straight and obvious. What I like to do on this is something that I'm going to discuss in another lesson is superimposed metric modulation. I know it sounds crazy, but what it really means is that you're playing something that sounds like it should be in a different time signature. So if we're in 4/4 time, we're going 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a... I can still do that, but play something that we'd hear in like 6 or 12/8 time, like this. So when you hear that, you think 1 triplet, 2 triplet, 3 triplet, 4 triplet, 1 triplet, 2 triplet. But if I play that in a 16th note context, 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a 1E and a 2E and a 3E, 4E and a 1. So it takes three bars of that before everything lines back up on one again. Okay, so that's metric, superimposed metric modulation. It makes it sound like you're changing meter, but you're not. All right, so I'll try to throw a little bit of that in. And then whatever comes out. All right, so I think I'm just going to shut up and play. Anybody hanging? My buddy Danny. All right, brother. Here we go. This is the ECM play along off Steve Houghton's album book and CD release, The Drum Set Soloist. And the whole book, which I have to switch to over here, is based on soloing as a drummer. So some of it is what we would call trading fours, where the band, after you get into the song, the band will play, and somebody solos for four bars, then the drummer solos, then somebody else solos for four bars, then the drummer. That's trading fours, trading eights, same thing, but eight measures. And then there's all kind of things in here with little solos and things that you can play over, like the one I'm about to do. So here we go. This is the ECM vamp. Here we go.
1, 2, 1, 2, 3. Thank you.
All right. So, sorry about that. I knew that one had a different level, and I was trying to turn it down. I hope it didn't blow you guys out. But alas, I couldn't get the mouse to work on the drum, so we were stuck with it. All right. So that is the ECM style. I encourage everybody to go out there and listen to some ECM music. Again, Pat Metheny, Jack DeJohnette, John Abercrombie. Please chime in and tell me if you've got favorite ECM artists or in that style. You know, it doesn't really have to be on the ECM label. And honestly, I think from my understanding, it seems to have stemmed from some Miles Davis stuff from like the mid to late 60s. Miles had Tony Williams on drums, and they started using these straight eighths. And then Herbie Hancock, who was in that same band, made an album called Maiden Voyage. And to me, Maiden Voyage is an ECM record, even though it's not on the ECM label. I don't even know if the ECM label existed yet, but it's got all the foundation of that, all the elements. So check out those records. Check out Miles Davis Sorcerer and ESP. Those are sick records. And then also check out Herbie Hancock's Maiden Voyage, especially the song Maiden Voyage really is in that ECM vein. Okay. Real quick, I just want to thank those who have thrown some tips my way. I've got a virtual tip jar there in the description of the thing, and I hate to be online, you know. I don't want to make people feel bad if they can't tip or anything like that, but the reality is that us musicians are out of work. Things may be opening up soon, but even for me, I have a feeling that those things are going to be a lot of acoustic acts with two guitar players, you know, acoustic guitar players on opposite sides of the stage. So for drummers, I don't know what's going to happen with us. I feel bad for wind instruments, too. Nobody wants a trumpet blowing COVID-19 riffs at them. But I do feel optimistic about the future and the music and all of our gigs. You know, it's just going to be a minute. So, thank you for those of you who throw tips in. You know, it doesn't have to be a lot. It's much appreciated. And that's not just for me. That's for all my colleagues out there, all right, trying to get by. And also, if you want to help me out, you could go to my YouTube channel, which is Jim Wall Music, all one word, lowercase. I put it in the description, a link to it. And just subscribe. You're not going to get spammed. You're not going to get a bunch of stuff. I used to be afraid to subscribe to somebody's channel. I thought I was going to get all kind of notifications and stuff. If you want notifications, you hit the little bell. Otherwise, there's no consequence except for the artist that you're subscribing to can start to benefit, you know, off of that. And also, if you want to swing by my website, it's got links to everything and all kinds of videos and audio and my Percussive Arts Academy and all kind of stuff on there. So swing by, say hi. All right, I think I'm going to do a solo. I'm going to play in five, which means five beats per measure. Let's see, we'll do it like a one, two, three, four, five, around that tempo, for those of you who are counting. And if anybody wants to check out something in five that's pretty cool, it's cliche, you know, all of us jazzers know it, but for those of you who don't, check out Dave Brubeck's song, Take Five, all right? And he had Joe Morello on drums, and it's classic stuff, man. He does a whole solo in five that's really beautiful, so check that out. We're going to do this solo, and then I'm going to play a couple grooves and then say bye-bye. All right, anybody hanging? No? If you are out there, let me know. Again, I can't tell if anybody's watching or not. I keep getting that stupid pop-up. Sorry, we're having trouble playing this video. Well, I'm having trouble playing the drums, but I'm doing it anyhow, right? Here we go. This is a solo in five. We'll see what happens. We'll be right back. right. So that's about it. I'm just going to play a little groove, a little slow groove, and get on out of here. Thanks for hanging with me. Thanks to those who watch this on my page, if I keep it up there, and those who watch it during the normal human hours. I just like this late night thing. First of all, I know that I can delete it if I have to. Secondly, this is a cool time to hang, man. You know, the whole world is kind of shut down. You're not going to get those calls and texts, and it's a good time to be creative. I encourage everybody to stay up all night and see what happens about 4 in the morning. All right, so here's just a little groove. I don't know what I'm going to do, but it's going to be 16th note based, and I'm just going to try to feel a little something and get out of here pretty quick. All right. Everybody be nice to each other, and that's it. That's my words of encouragement and wisdom, and we're all going to get through this mess. All right. Big love to everybody. Here we go. Love you guys. Have a great week. Get creative. Whatever it is you do, dig in and do it. You know, try new things. If you've been wanting to learn how to draw, start drawing. If you've been wanting to learn how to sing, like me, start singing in private. And whatever it is, you know, dig in. And life is short. All those things you've been putting off, dig in. It's time. This is your wake-up call. All right. I love you all. Thanks, man.